With Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about abfractions and whether you should restore them or not before you begin clear aligner treatment. And ultimately, that is your choice as the restorative dentist. I mean, as an orthodontist, if I saw something like this, I'm not treating that. I mean, yeah, you can, with Invisalign and some of the different companies out there, they will scallop around the abfractions, and you can ask them to do that with the trim line. However, it's not fully encompassing the tooth, which is going to change the forces. It's not going to move as effectively. It may not move as predictably. To me, certainly I don't want to have any unsupported enamel. That needs to go. I have seen teeth with abfraction snap. You got to realize every time you're taking, especially if it's got a high trim line and it's a more rigid kind of plastic, Invisalign's pretty gentle, but some of the other ones are not, you know? So obviously picking the right kind of aligner brand is important if the patient doesn't want to restore. Obviously trying to create some custom documents, and no, I don't have documents about abfraction specifically, because I mean, I probably, if you choose to treat this patient, even if you have some type of special informed consent where they have declining treatment to restore the abfractions and to begin the aligner treatment, I still think you're going to be ultimately responsible if something happens, because you know better. You know you shouldn't do that. Those teeth can definitely snap. I've seen them snap, not unlike they can snap with pins and posts. There is a little bit of language in most of the aligner informed consents. You need to make sure it's there. If not, you need to probably make your own custom one. I would prefer that you do restore them first. That would be my suggestion. All right, thanks.